How's it going, guys? I'm Theo Joe, and today we're going to be taking a look at the good old command prompt in Windows. And you may know this is a very useful tool, but there are a lot of features that are pretty much unknown, and dare I say, are secret features that make it even more useful. Now, this is going to be in Windows 10 particularly. That's what I'm using, but a lot of these are going to carry over in previous versions as well. I've got about 15 of these, so let's get started. First up is the ability to actually customize the prompt text itself. So when you start command prompt, it probably says the path of the current folder you're in, like C, and then either the user directory or maybe system32 if you're running as an administrator. But you can actually customize any of that text to say whatever you want. And you do this, for example, by typing in the prompt command. So you do prompt and then whatever text you want, and now that will be the text that shows up before whatever command you type in. So you can type in prompt hello, and now it will say hello, and then you type the commands after that. Obviously, having just some random word there is not really going to be very useful, so you can actually use the command prompt and then space slash question mark to show special codes that you can use to not just have words, but also dynamic information there as well, such as a timestamp or the version of Windows and stuff like that. So for example, maybe we don't want it to just show the file path, but we also want to have it as a timestamp. So if you're looking at a log later down the road, you know exactly when these commands were run. So to do this, you can look at the special codes, and what we would want to type in is prompt to say we're going to change this. Then we would use the command $T, which is the current time stamp code, and then we're going to do a space and then $B as a vertical line, and we're just kind of formatting at this point, another space, and then we're going to use the $P command, which will show the current path just like it usually does, and then we want to put that right arrow caret thing, so we're going to use the $G command to show the greater sign. So you can see after we do that, it now shows the timestamp and then the divider line and then the file path like it did before, so a little bit more useful. Also, if you ever mess it up and you want to go back, you can simply revert to the default by typing in prompt and nothing after that, and it will automatically go back. So you could also use this as some sort of prank if you want to mess with your friends. You could have it say catastrophic error or something like that, and then they won't know what's wrong with it. Might be kind of funny as long as you know how to put it back. One thing to keep in mind though is that when you use this command, it will actually reset once you restart the command prompt. If you wanted to have that by default and always show your customized one when you start command prompt, you have to do a quick registry edit. Now, I'm going to show you how to do that, but as usual, if you are not experienced with the registry editor at all, be very careful and maybe even avoid this trick, because messing with that registry and deleting something could literally ruin your entire version of Windows and you'll have to reinstall it. So just be very careful here. So what you do is you open up the registry editor and you need to find the key that's under computer, H key, current user, then software, then Microsoft, and then command processor. Now on the right side, after you enter that little folder, you're gonna right click, you're gonna create new, and then string value, and you want to name this auto run. And after you create that, you're going to right click on that key that you just made, the auto run one, and click modify, and then where it says value data, you're gonna type in whatever command you want to auto run as command prompt starts up. So in this case, if we want the prompt command to always have a certain format that we customize, like the one we just made, all we have to do is paste in that timestamp prompt code that we created before. And now you can see when we start up command prompt, it now automatically shows that customized prompt there. And this doesn't just have to be the prompt command. You could have this as any command you want to run automatically when you start command prompt, so use it wisely. All right, up next, this is another kind of useful one. So instead of customizing the prompt, maybe you want to customize the title that shows up in the title bar of the command prompt. And to do that, you just type in title and then whatever text you want. And again, this will reset after you close the command prompt, but if you want, you can put it in that auto run command in the registry and it will change it permanently. Okay, moving on. This is kind of two, and you might know these already, but first of all is the help command. I'm sure you know about this one. You just type in help and then it will basically list a bunch of very common command prompt commands that you can choose from. But you can also access help by typing in any command and then typing space and then a slash question mark. And I showed this in the previous one we did, and that will actually bring up a bunch of information about that command. And this doesn't necessarily have to be one of the commands that's built in to Command Prompt. For example, you could have one that's like SFC, System File Checker, and that's not gonna appear when you type in help, but you can still use the slash question mark command to show information about it, such as the syntax, some arguments or parameters in it, that sort of thing. All right, up next, we have a couple that we're gonna combine together, and that is how you can access previous commands that you might have typed in and you wanna either repeat these or just see what you typed in before. The first of which is simply using the arrow keys. If you use the up and down arrow keys, it will scroll through previous commands you did and paste them, so you can just press enter again to do it again. You can also get a list of previous commands you typed in that instance since you've started Command Prompt by typing in DOS key space slash history, and it will output a list of all the commands you've recently typed in. And finally, another good shortcut is simply pressing F7, and this will actually bring up not only a list of previous commands, but it'll also let you select them directly and then press enter, and then it will paste it. So if you don't have to keep scrolling through using the arrow keys, you can just select it right there. Pretty useful. All right, up next, this is a useful one if you want to have multiple commands executed on the same line. So you can do this by typing in two ampersands or and signs between the commands. So say we want to customize the title and the prompt at the same time, you can type in prompt, whatever text you want, and then the two and signs, and then the title command, whatever you want. When you hit enter, it'll do both at the same time. And you can also use this when you're doing that registry auto run command. If you want to have it execute multiple things, you can combine them with the ampersand and it'll do it all at once. All right, moving on, this is definitely a useful one, which allows you to put the output of a command onto the clipboard. So if you know that you're gonna be copying the command or you already executed it and you wanna go back and copy it this time, you'd simply type in the command and then a space and then a vertical line and then another space and then type clip after the command. So it'll look like this. And then now when you execute that command, it'll be copied to the clipboard and you can paste it on a forum if you're asking for help, into a text document, whatever you want. Related to this, the next one is that you can actually output an output to a file, not just the clipboard. And you do this by using the greater than sign, which is the right arrow, and then a space, and then the name of the file, so test.txt or whatever, and then it will output that to a text file, which is located in your default library folder for that user. So C users, Joe, or whatever. Keep in mind, if that file already exists, it will actually overwrite that file. But if you want to append the text results onto the file, so maybe you already have a file.txt and you want to add the results onto that, you can use two greater than signs and it will simply append the results to the end of it. For both of these commands, if you want, you can specify the file location so it doesn't just go to the default one, and that's simply by doing the greater than sign and then typing out the entire file path, and then it'll go to that file location. All right, this next one is a very simple shortcut, and that is Ctrl C. Now, normally, if you're in Windows, this always does a copy command, but in Command Prompt, it's special, and it actually aborts the currently running program or command. So if you're running something, and it's taken too long, or you didn't mean to run it, and it's kind of frozen, you could press Ctrl C, and it should abort that command, and then bring you the prompt again. So if Ctrl C doesn't do a copy and paste, how do you do a copy and paste? Well, that's the next tip. And that is, at least in Windows 10 and I think 8 as well, you actually highlight whatever you want in the command prompt, and then to copy, you actually right click and then it'll unselect, but now that text will be on the clipboard, and to paste, you just do Control V again like normally would and it will paste it. All right, these next couple are definitely super useful, and that is how you can easily open the command prompt to any path you want without having to type in the change directory command and then typing it all out. The first is when you're in any Explorer window to open the command prompt to that location, you can simply click in the path at the top, so it'll show your location C, whatever. You can click on that and type CMD, and now we'll open automatically the command prompt to that location. Also, you may not know this, but if you have the command prompt window open, you can actually drag and drop any folder or file into command prompt window, and it will automatically paste that file path. So if you want to quickly change the directory, you could also type in CD space and then drag it in and it'll do that. Or if you want to execute a command onto a certain folder, you can type the command, and then when you're ready to type in the path, you drag it on and it'll do it for you. Now, these next few aren't really secrets, but they're very useful tools that you may still not have known about. The first of which is the system file checker, and you use this command by typing in SFC, and typically the one you want to do is SFC space slash scan now, and this will actually check all the Windows files for anything that's corrupted. So this is very useful if Windows is misbehaving or complains about file errors or corrupted files. This is usually the first thing you want to do, and it will automatically repair anything that it finds. Now, this isn't a foolproof way of always fixing anything, but it's definitely something that's easy to try first. And if you want to know more commands with this, you can again use that slash question mark, and it'll show you a bunch of other syntax commands and parameters if you want to check them out. Another useful one is the ipconfig command. So you type in ipconfig, and it will bring up a bunch of information about all your network adapters. And you can also type in ipconfig space slash all, and it'll show you even more information, though that might not be useful to you. Now, this could be used for a few things if you just want to see quickly like the IP address, the local IP address of a network adapter. It'll show you all the network adapters and all their IP addresses all in one place. So this is really useful, and it'll also show you your internet IP address as well. And finally, this one's definitely not a secret, but I should point it out for those of you who don't know about it, and that is the ability to access a whole bunch of different properties and defaults to customize the command prompt in general. Now, to get to this, there's two ways. You can either right click on the title bar and then go to defaults, or you can simply left click on the little icon at the top left of the window and it'll bring up that same right click menu. Now, if you click defaults and properties, it'll bring up the same window, but I believe that if you do properties, it won't continue if you open it next. So if you want to change some settings that will stay changed, you have to go to the defaults menu, I believe. And in this menu, it'll show a few different tabs and a whole bunch of customization options, such as font sizes, colors of the window, editing options, the layout, all sorts of stuff that I'm not gonna get into, but I'm sure you can mess with it. So hopefully those tips and tricks will be useful the next time you use the command prompt. If you want, I've got some other videos on here that also have some cool tips and tricks on different stuff you might not have known about. So you can check those out, and until next time, be seeing you.